This is the line focus lens. It's a little bit hard filming this because I cannot really see because I'm wearing sunglasses. I don't want to be looking into very bright light all the time. But you can see that it has a focal image, which is a line, and if you focus it exactly right, then it's a very thin line, and it actually gets really hot. It's not a benign type of concentration, just like the spot focus, because you can see that the width of the light is only a fraction of the total width of the lens. So, and that's your concentration. See if I can get it. It becomes too hot to touch the wood. I don't think it will start smoking, but it is really quite effective. And I think that the solar cells that are planned to put into this beam are gonna suffer a little bit. I have to find out by trying. But of course, if you go a little bit closer, you can see. So, a little bit out of the focal plane, you can also get a concentration ratio. So this would be no concentration. This is 50%. This would be 75 or 4 times. And then you can go on. So you can basically determine the amount of concentration you want to achieve by varying the distance. This is the spot focus lens. And it's really, it's not playing around. Let's see if I can demonstrate. Of course, you know, if you put it very close to where you want it to hit, it's not going to concentrate very much, but as soon as you, let's say, see, this is quite an effective. Hi there, it's a sunny day and I've got my demo rig mounted on the table. It's not finished completely because it has to be. I have to be able to orient the horizontal beam here towards the sun easily. The sun is quite bright. If I do that, then the horizontal movements will be, well, you can basically turn almost 270 degrees with the base of the frame. I mounted the electrical motor here to the frame with a little bit of tape. Simply a cheap solution. I didn't want to go out to buy metal clamps and all that stuff. It works with a wire, like the vertical one. So this is the horizontal one. It's simply connected to a screw which is driven in the back of this beam. That's why you need it. You need, of course, to have a little bit of distance from the frame. This is the counterweight. So here you can see there's a wire connected. Goes over a little screw with something to protect it from sliding off. And then there's a weight, little wooden beam that will pull it down. It doesn't have to be heavy weight at all. It's just, it has to be enough to move it. If it's more than necessary, then it will start to basically cause problems. It can even jam. So we really don't want that. Let's see, next step will be connecting this. This is a serial connector, which I happen to have. This is actually a setup from last year. Looks a bit like a mess, but you can see clearly if it wants to focus that you have plenty of leads to drive two engines in two directions. You only need 4 for that, actually. So 4 out of these will be for that, and the rest will be for sensing. And that can be sensed. So then you have 2. So you have 9. Let's see if I can get this into focus. 9 holes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you have 5 left, which is plenty. Because if you have plus minus 5 volts, then you can use I2C or another protocol to transmit whatever you're measuring in the rig. So you put a little microcontroller in the rig itself, and it can do all kinds of measurements and send those signals back to base, let's say. It's going to be mounted out there on the worn out balcony. This is actually my little garden that I have out there, experimental. So here's some parsley, and I got actually a kidney bean. That's that one over here, the one I'm in the middle of the screen right now. It's a kidney bean growing. new kidney beans emerging there from the kitchen cupboard. And then I have a little micro greenhouse with basilicum. Basilicum. I'm not sure what that is in English. And all kinds of other plants that I found. I'm actually trying to grow some bamboo. But, so that's what I'll do to get the cable connected to the motors. To think about how I'm going to sense, because how I'm going to sense the angle. I can cut out a paper half circle and simply glue it to this beam. Put a little photo sensor over there, and then I can probably scan the angle of the horizontal frame, and I can do exactly the same with the vertical frame by making a half circle, gluing it to that beam, and then making a sensor there. And I happen to have a couple of these photo sensors, and of course I can also pry them out of a old mechanical mouse, because those type of devices have optical optocoupler sensors, I believe they're called. Anyway, so that's what I'm gonna do today, and I hope you find it interesting. And this is gonna work perfectly with a mirror as well, but this of course is a 33 by 33 frame. So for the mirrors I have 50 by 50 mirrors, so I would have to make a little bit bigger frame, but actually this is quite a workable way to approach the whole 2D or basically the horizontal and vertical mechanical control. It's really quite easy to make. So maybe I'll draw out a design, put it in Google SketchUp or something like that, and then you can replicate it. Thanks for listening.